The ANC in KwaZulu-Natal is refusing to implement the step-aside resolution taken by the party, saying that there are grey areas Luthuli House needs to resolve. Now, the provincial structure's request comes as it tries to reinstate a provincial deputy chairperson, that's Mike Mabuyakhulu, who's facing corruption charges in the Durban Commercial Crimes Court. Let's unpack the story now. We're joined by the Provincial Secretary of the ANC, that's Mdumiseni Ntuli. Mdumiseni, good morning. Thanks so much for your time on the AM report. To be honest, I'm confused by this resolution, this discussion that's taking place by the ANC in KZN. You know, there was so much fanfare that came with the decision from the mother body amid this climate of corruption around the country, that those members who are facing serious corruption charges should step aside at the very least until they've had their day in court. So what's the issue here?
Good morning, and thank you very much for having us on the show. And I'm glad that you are affording us an opportunity to clarify our position on this matter. First and foremost, it is not correct that we are reneging from our principled position. We're implementing that position, but in the course of implementation of any decision, there will always be constraints and challenges that requires the leadership to address the challenges that are impacting negatively on the implementation of the decision. Let me give you an example. What is the first of those challenges? When the National Executive Committee met in August and took a very correct decision that we must now begin to implement the conference resolutions about comrades who are charged or facing court cases having to step aside or step down, we agreed in the same meeting that it's one thing to have a decision of conference and agree that it must be implemented. It's another to implement it, which requires that you must articulate a framework and a process, because the party is very big. If you want uniformity across the country, there must be clarity on processes and procedures. Where are we having a problem now? We took a decision that comrades must step aside and that they must appear before the Integrity Commission. Maybe let me just explain what the resolution says. Mm-hmm. The resolution says that the ANC must demand that those amongst us who happen to be in conflict with the law must be directed to appear before the Integrity Commission. If they fail to do so, it is therefore the ANC that must impose disciplinary measures against them. Mm. Now, in this case, we've had comrades who have appeared before the Integrity Commission. It makes findings. Part of the findings that it makes is that, look, you have a provincial deputy chairperson that voluntarily withdrew from the list to parliament, which would have made him either a minister or an MEC in the context of the problem. He voluntarily stepped down, and when the NEC also said, let's implement this resolution, he came back to the NEC and said, I'm prepared to stay at home. Allow me to stay at home and take me to the Integrity Commission so that it will make a determination about the extent to which my court case is impacting on the standing of the movement. Mm-hmm. The Integrity Commission comes back with a recommendation that says, with all the facts that have been presented before it, we are of the view that this comrade must be permitted to resume his duties in the ANC. Mm-hmm. The first challenge that the National Executive Committee has an urgent task to resolve. What happens in a case where an Integrity Commission makes a recommendation to the Provincial Executive Committee that is contrary to the view of the Provincial Executive Committee? Should the PEC stand up and say, what you are saying, we don't agree with it, and because we don't agree with it, we are going to proceed in this way? Where will that place the standing and the integrity of the Commission itself? Mm-hmm. The second issue that has not been clarified, which we think the public must be aware of, is that the NEC was meant to elaborate, as it has said in its own statement in August, guidelines and procedures on how to implement this decision in this way. When we are a member of parliament, once you miss a certain number of meetings, you no longer qualify to remain in parliament. When you are a council, once you miss a certain number of meetings, you are automatically expelled from council. If the NEC decision and its approach is that the primary meeting, the purpose of stepping aside, of stepping down, is that people must resign, the National Executive Committee must be specific and say people must resign. Yeah. The stepping aside and going to the Integrity Commission is a complex process, because once you have findings from the Integrity Commission, you then have to say, what do we say with these findings of our Integrity Commission, where we refer the matter on the basis that on our own we felt that we were not in a position to determine what should be the way forward. So that is a complexity that we're raising as a provincial executive committee. It's not a matter of a deflecting or running away from the conference resolution. We are very committed that we remain the principal guidance of the values of the movement, and we belong to the Parliament of the People, and this Parliament of the People has to conduct itself on daily basis and through its own leadership in a manner that inspires confidence to society. But where there are complications, we can't be populist. We must agree that we've taken many resolutions since the last conference, and we've not yet implemented all of them, because we always have to implement decisions based on the balance of evidence and deal with the reality at on hand without emotion. Mdumiseni, on the basis of what becomes going from the
Yeah. Mdumiseni, yes. There are a couple of issues I want to address with you. First, sure. you asked the question, you know, should the PEC disagree with the decision from the Integrity Committee? And then you continue and you ask, does this not undermine then that committee itself? And is the answer not yes, that the PEC should be able to disagree with the Integrity Committee as it relates to decisions around how it deals with one of its members embroiled in serious allegations of corruption in connection with 28 million rand that was paid for a jazz festival that never materialized? This is what Mike Mabuyakhulu is accused of, along with 16 other people. So you ask the question, should you disagree as the PEC with the Integrity Committee? Is the answer not yes? Because then it shows that you, as the provincial structure, you are committed to the democratic process as your party deals with this scourge of corruption that is dogging our country.
If you simplify the approach that the PEC should take, you are correct that the answer should be that we must disagree with the PEC, with the Integrity Commission. But that is a narrow approach to a complex issue. The province of KwaZulu-Natal is part of a unitary organization led by the National Executive Committee. It cannot elaborate its own processes and procedures, which may not be consistent with what is happening in that part of the country. That is a job of the National Executive Committee in the context of the ANC. We're a unitary organization. Even if we want to disagree with the Integrity Commission, that must be because it is regulated within the national framework of our organization. And that is why we said to the national leadership of the ANC, without an elaboration on this matter, you are going to create an environment where provinces take decisions that are not consistent and which will then position the ANC as a federal organization rather than what is its own true character. And that is the issue that we're raising with the leadership of the ANC. And that's a complexity we said.
Yeah.
We can't run away from this matter and say, because we are obviously very unhappy about the fact that comrades are accused of such a serious corruption. But we can't be reckless. You can't create a structure, call it an integrity commission. It makes a finding. You have no national elaborated guidelines on how you must respond to its own findings. And then you demolish it by saying that, look, what you did there is wrong, you must stop. We are continuing in this way. Because then the integrity commission will have no status. It will have no impact on its work. Now you need a national elaborated guideline that would say, in case where comrades are facing this kind of issues, the route to the integrity commission is merely to explain the circumstances of their own case, but it doesn't take away the fact that they must step aside.
Yeah.
And if the national guidelines were to be specific like that, we're prepared to say, Comrade Mike, we've heard what the integrity commission said. We appreciate that we have appeared before them and we're honest and candid, but we still believe, based on this guideline, that you must step aside and resign as a deputy chairperson of the ANC. But you can't have a KwaZulu Natal formula on a matter that the ANC has already discussed and adopted an approach that the national officials will elaborate guidelines and the framework through which the decision must be implemented.
Yeah. I suppose the challenge then comes is if decisions like these are taken and members are put back into their positions while investigations are ongoing, while the court process is ongoing, and that person comes back and is actually found guilty of the corruption they are then accused of. So you talk about, you know, the values of the movement and the fact that provinces can't stray from the national framework. I suppose the follow-on discussion then is, how is that read by the public, by the people who support you, if those people are indeed found guilty?
It will be read in a very bad way. And we hope that the public will not get into a point where they must read it in that way, because the National Executive Committee should therefore appreciate that the task that the national officials have not concluded is now impacting adversely on the implementation of the resolution of the National Conference and the decision of the National Executive Committee. This is not unique about this resolution. Any conference resolution, you don't exit conference and go implement it without a clarity on procedures and processes that can be understood and be explained by each and every member across all corners of South Africa. Because if you don't do that, it is also flying against the values of the ANC that a province in KwaZulu Natal will do something that a province in the Western Cape of the same organization would not do. So we are hopeful that the president of the ANC, the secretary general, and the rest of the national officials would understand that in the course of implementing a noble and correct decision of our movement, there are challenges that they themselves are called upon to stand up and address in terms of the framework and the procedures. I want to reassure the people of KwaZulu Natal and South Africans. The PEC of KZN is a very courageous leadership. If the guidelines were to say to us, going to the Integrity Commission is for that comrade to explain themselves, but they must resign, we'll be the first to announce that those comrades must resign from their responsibility. Resign in Parliament, resign as councillors, and for the Deputy Chair of the ANC to resign as a member of the Provincial Executive Committee. But we don't want to create a KZN African National Congress way of doing things. Even on a matter that has served on the National Executive Committee, and there was an agreement that the apex leadership of our movement must elaborate a clear and a precise process of procedure and guidelines for the implementation of our decision. We can't do that. We have a responsibility to build the ANC, and building the ANC must not deflect or move away from the character and the unitary character of our movement.
Well, listen, thanks very much for your time this morning. Unfortunately, we have run out of time, but certainly a developing story that we will continue to track for you. Mdumiseni Ntuli speaks on behalf of the ANC in KwaZulu-Natal.